Hey, my name's Tanner James with DJ TJ Training, and I am going to tell you about the purpose of a DJ mix, what to put in a DJ mix, what do you do, somebody wants one from you, how do you, what do you do? I'm gonna help you, I'm gonna tell you what to do. So I recently had a club inquire about booking me as a resident DJ for their club, and they wanted a mix from me. And so as I was putting my mix together and formatting it, I realized that a lot of DJs don't know what they're doing. They don't know how to make a mix. They don't know what the point of one is and all that. And from the other side, when I am booking DJs, when I'm hiring DJs onto my team, I have them make mixes for me. And I realized that a lot of DJs, again, don't know what they're doing. So in this video, I want to talk to you about why it's important. So let's first think about why somebody would be requesting a mix from you, right? They're interested in booking you and they want a mix from you. What are they looking for? They want to make sure that you are the right fit for them. They want to make sure that you are going to play the right music, the music that they actually want to hear. They don't want to hire a country DJ if they want to hear hip hop music, and they don't want to hire an EDM DJ if they want to hear top 40. So before you make the mix, you want to actually figure out what they're looking for, and you want to make sure that you line up the mix with what they want to hear. Let's think of it as if you were going to hire a DJ onto your team. You have so much work coming in and booked that you need to hire another DJ to allow you to handle all this work, and you want him to make you a mix. What do you want the mix to be like? You just want a mix long enough that, number one, you know that they know how to beat match, how to make smooth transitions. Two, they have the right song selection. And three, that they can just put it all together, make sure that it all sounds right. So the first part of the beat matching is done in just a few songs. You just want to make sure that they can line up the beats, make sure it sounds good, all that kind of stuff. So having a mix that's 2 hours long is complete overkill. And again, if you're a busy person, you don't want to listen to a 2 hour long mix. It's too much. You want it quick, you want it concise, and you want to be done. So a 20 to 30 minute mix is perfect. It gets just what you need. When you're creating this mix, you want to make sure that you have the right elements. You want to make sure that you have the right songs. You want to make sure that if you are hiring a top 40 DJ, that DJ puts in top 40 music. He doesn't go off playing crazy other genres of music that you didn't ask for. You want to make sure that he has that music. Lastly, you don't want to play songs the whole entire time if that's not how it is. You want to make it seem like it's a real live performance. So make sure that you keep the songs to about what you would play. If a wedding client asks you for a mix, you don't want to play songs that are 5 minutes long, right? You want to keep them shorter. You want to keep them condensed because, again, you only have 20 to 30 minutes. So when you're putting the mix together and you're kind of programming it out, you want to make sure that the songs flow. You want to make sure that the beats sound good. You want to have them actually line up, right? You want to make sure that when you're beat matching them, they sound good together. And you want to make sure that the songs aren't jarring. You want to make sure that they flow together. Sometimes some songs, they may be the same BPM, but they don't flow together. You want to make sure that they do flow together. As a bonus tip, I would do a voiceover at the beginning or the end just to talk about what the mix was about, just so that they could have a more clear understanding. I actually create mixes and put them on my website so that if a client goes there, they don't even have to ask me for one. They can just go on there, click it, and listen to it. So if a client asks you for a mix, now you know what to do. You can make mixes, you can make sample mixes, 20, 30 minutes, put it on your website, which will help when somebody goes to your website to see if you are the right fit for their event. So again, keep the mixes relatively short, make sure they sound good, make sure they're beat matched, make sure that the songs all line up, they're not just crazy songs all thrown together because they're cool songs. Make sure it actually, when you're playing the songs, they actually flow together, they look good, they sound good, and it all works out. So if you have any comments or questions about making DJ mixes, go ahead, leave them down below in the comment section and we can talk about it. And I will see you guys next week.